people are not willing to forgive you. People are not willing to forget your mistakes. And maybe you yourself are not willing to forget your mistakes. You keep thinking about them. You keep beating yourself up over them. But then you just take this one statement, وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَى مَنِ اتَّبَعَ الْهُدَى. And you realize how universal this is, how powerful this statement is, that Allah is offering you, me, and every human being on the face of this earth a chance at living at peace with themselves, living a life of dignity and honor, realizing that honor and dignity does not come or cannot be taken away from the words of others. You see, even though Musa alayhi salam is an honored messenger of Allah, and we respect him, we say alayhi salam, we honor him because he's the most mentioned messenger in the Quran. At the same time, when the Fir'aun was talking to him, he said, وَلَا يَكَادُ يُبِينَ هَذَا الَّذِي هُوَ مَهِينَ وَلَا يَكَادُ يُبِينَ. I'm going to follow this guy, this humiliated convict. Look, he's got a stutter. He can't even talk clearly. He can't even do that. Even in the course of this conversation, the Fir'aun hurled insults at Musa alayhi salam. What are we learning about that? We're learning that people's words don't take away your honor. People's comments cannot take away who you are to Allah. And therefore, they should not take away who you are to yourself. And as hurtful as they are. Think about Maryam salamun alayha. One of the most honored women in Islam, isn't that so? A woman mentioned by name in the Quran. No other prophet, you get to hear, you know, Nuh, Ibn, and you don't hear the name. But you don't hear about Nuh alayhi salam's father. You know, and even when the father is mentioned, Ibrahim alayhi salam, it's not mentioned in a good light. You know, if qala Ibrahimu li abihi azar, it's not mentioned in a good light. But Isa alayhi salam, Allah honors this woman so much, he says, Isa ibn Maryam. He mentions her name. He highlights her. This is a surah dedicated by her name. And this woman was so humiliated publicly by people. She was so degraded by the comments of people. Then she was afraid of facing that. She wished she could be dead before she had to face them. I want you to understand that contradiction. People humiliating someone is not the same as Allah humiliating them. People humiliating someone is not the same as Allah humiliating them. The highest honor you can get, one of the highest honors you can get, is the angels of Allah descend to speak to you on behalf of Allah. That's Maryam salamun alayha. And on the flip side, she's the one that's going to be yelled at in public and shamed in public for holding a baby in her hands at the same time. So we often take, we perceive ourselves, we perceive our place, we perceive our sense of safety based on what others want us to see. People, the impression people cast on us, we make that a permanent part of how we see ourselves. But there's one thing here that Allah has offered, and if we just commit to that, then we're okay. وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَىٰ مَنِ اتَّبَعَ الْهُدَىٰ. And this is what I'm going to leave you with. Whoever followed the guidance. What is so hard about following Allah's guidance? Fir'aun wasn't told to fast 30 days. He wasn't told to make hajj. Fir'aun wasn't told to observe halal meat. The Sharia hadn't even been revealed yet. The only thing he was being told, the only thing, was to humble himself and not hurt people. Be grateful to Allah, acknowledge your Rabb, and don't hurt people. We happen to have a Sharia, we happen to have things that are made haram for us. And by the way, all the things that are made haram for us are only things that are harmful for us. There is nothing, if you fed yourself that somehow following Allah's guidance is a really hard thing, that is the biggest lie the shaitan has been able to sell you, and the biggest con, the biggest deception that you've accepted. This deen, yuridullahu bikum al-yusr. Allah wants ease for you. Everything that he prohibited is because staying away from it makes your life easier. Yuridullahu liyukhaffifa ankum. Allah wants to lighten your burden. He wants my life to become lighter. He doesn't want me to live a life of stress and anxiety. People say things like, how come riba is haram? Well, if riba isn't haram, you're going to just go crazy with your credit card. And then guess what? 2 years from now, you're taking anti-anxiety pills on your credit card to deal with the anxiety of being in debt. and you're buried. It's because of, oh, why can't I just take a student loan? Why can't I just take this loan or that loan or the other loan? And when you engross yourself in that kind of debt, then college graduates that have graduated 5 years are still paying off their tuition in riba. And this was supposed to be a good plan. This is what Allah was saving you from. This is something Allah was saving you from. Everything He made haram. Everything He made haram. He made haram for a reason. To help you and me. That's the only reason. He didn't make it haram to make your life hard. يُحَرِّمُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْخَبَائِثِ. So when Allah here says, on the tongue of Musa alayhi salam, to go tell the Fir'aun, peace and safety and honor will come upon those who follow Allah's guidance. It is only and only shaitan who will convince you that when you follow Allah's guidance, your safety won't be there anymore. When you follow Allah's guidance, your peace will go away. People will look at you funny. If you follow Allah's guidance, you'll lose your status in society. If you follow Allah's guidance, people will think you're backwards. And if you follow Allah's guidance, then what honor do you have? What honor do you have? You know, because you're not like everybody else. Because now what's honorable? What's honorable is what is popular, right? In the new world, what's honorable is what's popular. And you'll notice the more obscene you are, the more pointless you are, the more ridiculous you are, the more purposeless you are, easily the more popular you can get. The more popular you can get. So why would I want to go in the other direction? Allah has taught us to swim upstream. He's telling a king, Musa is telling a king, you're bankrupt because you don't have salam. We have to internalize that. We have to live this ayah. وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَى مَنِ اتَّبَعَ الْهُدَىٰ.